see
good
you.
Good to see you.
Hello, I'm Jeanne. This is Council Close-Ups. Today I'm with Emily Resseger. She's an environmental scientist for the council. We're exploring her neighborhood in Minneapolis, Standish Erickson, this morning. Talk about what you love about this place.
You know, I've lived here for 10 years and I've been on the neighborhood board for 5, so I think about the neighborhood a lot. And what I really love about it is that it just brings out the best that Minneapolis has to offer. You can get here by transit. We have 2 train stations. This is the 38th Street station right by my house. Then you can walk past a number of really awesome neighborhood businesses, and then you can end up at Lake Hiawatha or Minnehaha Creek. And I think that that's one of the great things about our region is how accessible all these resources are.
Lovely. Why don't we take a walk through the neighborhood?
Sounds good.
Tell us about some of your favorite haunts in this neighborhood.
Well, a lot of places have opened since I've lived here, which is really exciting. One of my favorites is Northbound Brew Pub, which we just passed a little while I was back. I was able to invest there before it opened, so now I get to drink free beer for life.
Wow, that's an investment.
Yeah, so as you can imagine, I'm there a lot. But also Colossal Cafe, which is a great cafe that was up on 42nd, just moved to 38th right by my house. I've been there like 4 times in the last month. The library is great. It's really nice to be able to walk up here. I take my animals to a vet over up on 42nd. I just love that I can walk to as many places and get my needs met as possible in my neighborhood, and I try really hard to do that.
Emily, did you grow up in the Twin Cities?
No, I'm actually from Cleveland, Ohio, but I've lived here for about 13 years.
And what do you like about the Twin Cities region as a whole?
One of the things I really love about the Twin Cities is the minute it gets it all nice in the spring, everybody drops what they're doing, they just run outside and play in a park or run around a lake. I've just never seen people so excited about the weather.
This is a beautiful spot. Do you like to spend time outdoors?
Yeah, I do. I especially like anything I can do around a lake. So the last couple years I've done the YWCA Women's Triathlon, which meant that I spent a lot of time biking through this park, looking at the lake, and then ending up at Lake Nokomis. So biking there, running around the lake, and that's actually where the triathlon is, right at Lake Nokomis, which is just south of here. So
did I hear you say you're a home brewer?
I am.
How did you get started with that?
I don't even remember. It seemed like it'd be a fun thing to try. It's pretty easy to get started, although it's also one of those hobbies where you end up buying a lot of stuff really fast. But, it's like you just need a burner and a pot. And I think I had a friend who was doing it. So, yeah, at this point, it's easiest to do in the summer because you can just put your burner outside. And then when it inevitably overflows, you haven't ruined your stove, which always happens to me.
Tell us what you do from day to day at the council.
My job is really variable, which is what I love about it. Everything I do has to do with making sure the rivers, streams, and lakes in the metro area are the best shape they can be. So looking at clean water in the metro, but the work I do really varies. Sometimes I work and review plans for cities, comprehensive surface water management plans. So making sure cities are developing in sort of a way that supports clean water. We have a fairly large group that monitors the rivers, streams, and lakes in the region at the council. So I help manage the data that's collected so that we can use it for assessments so that scientists outside the council can use our data. So we spent the last 2 years working on a new website that could be really user-friendly so others could download and use our data. So I've been working on that. I also take the data we collect and analyze it to understand if the rivers and stream quality are getting better or worse. So if the phosphorus levels are going up or down, if the chloride levels are going up or down over time, also analyze that data to understand where our sources for pollutants in the metro area are.
Talk a little bit about water, like what it means to you or the kind of importance of water.
It's really important to Minnesotans, and I don't think they think about it, but it's really ingrained in their ethos of who they are. I feel like we're really used to driving by a lake, and that's the way it is, but not everybody is so lucky, and so many Minnesotans have a history of fishing or boating, going up to the cabin. And I think at this point, I sort of want Minnesotans to bring that back into their consciousness, how important our water bodies are, because we can improve them. I think sometimes we assume that they're degraded and that's how it is, but that's not true. If we really value them, we can improve them so that we can enjoy swimming in them again.
What I'm learning here is that you are extremely creative. I mean, in addition to having a scientific mind, Have you always been that way? And how did that manifest when you were young?
I was really into Legos as a child. Actually, one of my proudest Lego creations was a community bathroom. So it had like a toilet and a shower. And so I was very proud of that. I actually think the toilet was way too big for a Lego person to use, but that did not stop me. So I always say that was sort of where I like first got into water, was with my Legos. So.
What do you like about working at the council specifically?
I really personally like that it's sort of cliche, but that I'm working towards the greater good, that I'm, you know, working to help improve lakes and rivers and streams for every resident of the Twin Cities metro area. I also really love working with the people, seeing my coworkers in environmental services, in, you know, planning, just like everywhere, you know, you can see how proud all council employees are to be serving the region. And I think they all take it really seriously. And, you know, when you get together with on a project with a bunch of different folks, just their energy in doing the best they can for the region, it really shows, and it makes you feel really good about your job.
Emily, you are really a multi-talented woman. I've enjoyed our conversation. Thanks so much.
Me too. This has been great.
If you'd like to know more about the work of Emily and the Metropolitan Council, visit our website at metrocouncil.org. Let's keep walking. What a nice day.